Looking for magic cards? At flipsidegaming.com you can now use the promo code LVD to get a 10% discount on orders over $10 while supporting the channel at the same time. Hello and welcome to another Magic Arena gameplay video. Today we're taking a look at a blue-red deck built around a Ral Storm Conduit from War of the Spark, a 4-mana planeswalker that starts out at 4 loyalty and has a static ability saying whenever we cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, Ral deals 1 damage to target opponent or planeswalker, and that static ability is what enables the infinite damage combo alongside 2 copies of expansion, since if there's a spell on the stack with converted mana cost 4 or less, doesn't even have to be your own spell, can also be one from the opponent, we target it with expansion, which of course will trigger Ral's static ability, and then cast a second copy of expansion, targeting our first expansion, then we get to create an infinite loop of expansions copying each other, which will keep triggering Ral's static ability, dealing 1 damage to the opponent with every time the loop is performed. So we basically get to deal infinite damage to our opponent and to win on the spot. There's other ways to combo off with Ral as well, involving cards like Double Cast and Ral's -2 to create infinite number of copies, or we can use Narset's Reversal as well alongside expansion to perform the combo. But Double Cast and Narset's Reversal aren't great cards by themselves, whereas Expansion Explosion and Ral Storm Conduit are still fine cards, so we just happen to have the infinite damage combo, but we don't rely on it to win the game. We're more of a counter-burn deck that has a few counter spells, a few burn spells, and we try and burn the opponent out after drawing more cards. And then of course Ral has some abilities as well. The +2 lets us scry 1, and the -2 says when we cast our next instant or sorcery spell this turn, we get to copy that spell and choose new targets for that copy. So the -2 works great alongside powerful instants and sorceries like Ral's Outburst, which lets us deal 3 damage to any target at instant speed, and we also get to look at the top 2 cards of our library, put one of them into our hand and the other one in the graveyard. The reason why we're not playing cards like Chemist's Insight in this deck is because of the Planeswalker Narset that's showing up quite a lot in recent lists, whereas Ral's Outburst is unaffected by it. So let's take a look at our entire decklist, starting out with our 1-drops, where we've got the full 4 copies of Opt, which is a nice cheap spell that lets us scry 1 and then draw a card, and unlike Chemist's Insight, if we cast this in the opponent's turn, it doesn't get affected by Narset too badly, and it's also a cheap spell we can put on the stack and then copy twice with expansion to set up our infinite damage combo with Ral Storm Conduit. Same goes for Shock, which can deal 2 damage to any target at instant speed for just 1 mana, that also functions as a cheap removal spell. Then at 2 mana we've got 2 copies of Negate to counter target non-creature spell, which is great in a format full of planeswalkers, can help us counter 3 mana Teferi even if we're on the draw, because our deck likes to play instant speed and otherwise that card could be problematic. Then we have 2 copies of Search for Ascanta, which is our main card draw engine in the deck outside of a big explosion drawing us extra cards, and all the cards in our deck are non-creature spells, so the hit rate on a flipped Ascanta activation is quite high. Then we've got the full 4 copies of Lightning Strike, and as you'll notice, a lot of the removal spells in this deck can also go upstairs and burn out the opponent. So if we're playing against a more controlling deck, for example, where Lightning Strike and Shock aren't too useful at killing creatures since their opponent doesn't have any, we can just start pointing them upstairs or maybe take out some Planeswalkers and then eventually burn the opponent out. So this blue-red deck plays quite a bit differently than the typical Esper control deck with very few win conditions, since we can just burn people out. Then at 3 mana we've got our only sweeper in the form of Firing Cannonade. It's not a great sweeper, a lot weaker than a card like Kaya's Wrath or even Deafening Clarion would be, but it is an instant, so we can play it at instant speed and maybe catch the opponent off guard, dealing 2 damage to each non-pirate creature, and also plays great alongside expansion since we can copy Firing Cannonade even at instant speed for a total of 5 mana, dealing 4 damage to each non-pirate, which does make a pretty big difference if we need to deal with green decks where the creatures are quite a bit larger. And then we also have the full 4 copies of Ionize as our counterspell of choice, countering target spell and dealing 2 damage to that spell's controller, so this kind of adds on to the counter-burn strategy of the deck, where we get to whittle the opponent's life total down with our burn spells, and Ionize helps there too, and of course it also plays great alongside Ral's static ability, which also keeps dealing damage to the opponent or their planeswalkers. And then to stay on theme, we also have the full 4 copies of Ral's Outburst to deal more damage and provide more card draw. And then we also have 1 copy of Ral Izzet Viceroy as an additional planeswalker that can provide a bit of card advantage, and then the -3 can also help us deal with larger creatures, and the -8 emblem is also a game-winning play, and then the full 4 copies of Expansion Explosion as a pretty versatile card. Expansion can help us copy cards like Ral's Outburst, which is pretty good value, and an Explosion can also draw us quite a few cards if there's no Narset in play. And the mana base is pretty straightforward, 8 islands, 9 mountains, 4 steam vents, and 4 sulfur falls. We're not playing any copies of Niv-Mizzet, we're not playing any crackling drakes, which would be okay inclusions, but we just don't want to give our opponents any targets for removal spells, and we can easily win without them. So that's the deck, now let's jump in some games and see how the deck does. Alright, we're on the play, and seems fine. Can use Opt to find more lands. Playing 25 total. Usually you see 26 lands in control decks, but because we have 4 copies of Opt, we can get away with fewer. And don't need another expansion, even though it would be the second one to set up the combo, and there's Ra'al, so... Alright, now we just need another expansion, and then we would have the combo, although against a white weenie deck it's not going to be trivial to let Ra'al survive for an entire turn to set up the combo. Against white weenie, the card we want to draw the most is probably Fiery Cannonade, although it's going to be a tapped Sacred Foundry into another Hunted Witness. That's fine. No need to Lightning Strike those. So we get to play our land, say go, keep up Ionize, and otherwise we can just Opt. Could also expansion the Opt, but I think I would rather keep this in case we can find another copy to set up the combo. Dreadhorde Arcanist, so this could be a Feather deck that resolves. Do have to watch out for Sheltering Light making it indestructible, but we can just Lightning Strike it for now. And then maybe Lightning Strike it a second time if it doesn't die. So we'll bottom that, Ra'al's Outburst. So it looks like they do have the Sheltering Light. And they're gonna go for it. Fair enough. So the problem now with using Lightning Strike main phase on the Arcanist is that our opponent can resolve whatever they want. So we probably have to let the Arcanist hit us. Could also Outburst it right now that they're tapped out. If they resolve Feather, we're gonna be sad though. Could try and resolve Ra'al, hope it survives. If our opponent plays any pump spell, then they get to play twice thanks to the Arcanist, and then Ra'al likely dies. So it seems a bit risky to run him out. So I think what I'm gonna do is just pass a turn and then keep up Ionize for a potential Feather, and then end of turn use Outburst to kill the Arcanist. Hope they don't have a second Sheltering Light in hand. Alright, opponent goes for Samwitz Sprint. So we could try and kill Dreadhorde Arcanist in response. I think I'm gonna let that resolve still. This does mean that Outburst end of turn is no longer gonna kill the Arcanist. But again, I think it's too important that we keep up Ionize for a potential Feather. And then we can just Outburst their face end of turn. Opponent passes. Outburst face. And dig a bit deeper into our deck. We still have a Lightning Strike to take out Arcanist. And another Ionize or a land. Think we're taking the land here, so at some point we can maybe play Ra'al and still have a Lightning Strike. For now I'm still gonna pass, make the exact same play we made last turn, but now we get both Ionize and Lightning Strike. And then next turn we can maybe deploy our Planeswalker. It's gonna be Aurelia, definitely worth countering. And then we can also Lightning Strike the Arcanist while they're tapped out here. Now we're not out of the woods yet, opponent still has 2 cards in hand. But this is a good opportunity to resolve our Planeswalker. And another Outburst seems great. Can even copy our Explosion if we wanted to, or we can copy the Outburst. It's gonna be a Gideon Blackblade. Wish we had a Negate in hand, but we might just have to use our Burn spells to finish off for Gideon here. Hit Ra'al for 2. That's fine. I guess copying Explosion is better than copying the Outburst here. So we'll minus. For every action, there's a reaction. And then X equals 3. We'll aim at Gideon. And then we'll draw the cards.
I've fought worse.
Alright, so we get to kill Gideon, and we made sure to make it so Gideon died exactly, and we didn't waste any points of damage, so we could deal 3 to our opponent as well in the process. And yeah, opponent scoops it up, just too many cards to work with now, even though we drew quite a few lands, we had a backup Rawl and still an Outburst in hand, so we were pretty far ahead there. Alright, we're on the draw, hand seems keepable. Let's see what we're up against. Turn 1 Breeding Pool. We can Lightning Strike most mana creatures outside of Paradise Druid. Say go. It's gonna be Jade Light Ranger. I think with the trigger on the stack we'll shock it. So if it did end up as a 4-3, we make sure to kill it before it picks up those +1/+1 counters. Branchwalker Graveyard, Nissa. Let's see if that stays on top. Does. Alright, so we could keep up Ionize, or we could try and resolve Search Raskanta. Since we're missing land drops, I think I want to get the Search Raskanta in play so we can use the card selection to make sure we hit our land drops. And Nissa's the real card we want to counter, so that's what we want to keep the Ionize for. Whereas the creatures we can kind of deal with our burn spells. That can go to the graveyard. And land is good. So I think we take 2 here. So we have the flexibility of keeping up Outburst and Ionize. If we play the Stabbed, then we don't have a great end of turn play if they don't play into Ionize. Other than, I guess, Lightning Strike on Jade Light, which would be okay. But I would rather just Outburst. So we can keep hitting our land drops, our opponent passes. Kill the Jade Lights. Opponent might have a Frilled Mystic. Fair enough. But now if we draw Fiery Cannonade, we can wipe the board. I guess I'll keep it just so we can go Lightning Strike plus Ionize. So Lightning Strike, the Frilled Mystic now. Since otherwise we're gonna end up taking a bit too much damage. Make sure we can keep up Ionize for Nissa. But now we're in a bit of a difficult spot since our opponent is just going to keep passing. If they have another Filled Mystic, we're in trouble. Alright, what do we think about Steam Vents? I think we graveyard that for now. Try and find more cheap interaction. And also try and flip Ascanta faster. Can't really afford to tap out for any of our Planeswalkers here. Gotta keep up Ionize and take our beatings from the Jade Light and the Lanner Elves. But once the Ascanta transforms, we can maybe afford to run out both Rawl and Ionize in the same turn. So this is where having a Fiery Cannonade to clean up would be great. Lightning Strike, so if we put the Lightning Strike in the graveyard, Ascanta doesn't transform yet, so I think we keep that on top. And then we don't have to Lightning Strike main phase since our opponent could have another Frilled Mystic. So we'll just pass a turn and then Lightning Strike in the opponent's turn while keeping up Ionize. And then we'll kill the Branchwalker. Hydroid Crasis could also be problematic. It's gonna be Wild Growth Walker instead. If our opponent plays an Explore creature second main, we might just have to Ionize that. Or we can Lightning Strike the Wild Growth Walker and then hope to top deck into a Fiery Cannonade. But we only have 2 of those in the deck, so it's not very likely. So I think I'll just Lightning Strike the Branchwalker. And then we're fine Ionizing whatever they play if it grows a Wild Growth Walker. And if it's a Frilled Mystic, we'll Ionize that as well. So that happens. Take 3. Opponent lets us untap. And Rawl's Outburst. I think we have to put that in the graveyard just to transform Ascanta. Pick up another Outburst, that's good. So the problem here is if we try and resolve Rawl, opponent casts Frilled Mystic, we Ionize the Frilled Mystic, then our opponent resolves Nissa and we're dead. So I don't think we can afford to go for it here. Just gonna have to keep up Outburst and Ionize. And if our opponent attacks, do we go for the Outburst anyway? I think so. Outburst a Wildgrowth Walker, which threatens to become bigger. And we still have an I9 to protect. And if our opponent casts Thrilled Mystic, then they can't resolve Nissa. Now if they have a Negate on top or a Spell Pierce, we're pretty dead, but not much we can do about that. And it looks like they have a Negate as well. Alright, well. That was going to be a tough match to win regardless. A deck that has both pressure with creatures and counter spells to back it up is going to be a difficult matchup for our deck. Yeah, I don't think there's much we can do other than hope to top deck into Fiery Cannonade, but even then, we're dead to the Nissa. Did find another expansion, so we were one expansion away from having the combo, but that was going to be difficult to pull off in these circumstances. If we take Shock, we can't copy it with Rall since we don't have the mana. So yeah, we're pretty dead here. Alright, GG's. Alright, we're on the play, hand seems fine. And I'm probably gonna take two to cast Opt. Although I guess we can also just play this tapped and then wait to see what the Opt needs to find us, since right now both lands and spells are fine draws. I guess I can buy that. Turn 2 play Ascanta, turn 3 have the flexibility of Opt plus whatever we draw in the meantime. Up against the red-black, Grixis. Alright, getting the turn 2 Ascanta in play against Grixis is pretty good. We'll keep the land for now. And then we can Opt end of turn. If they cast a Thought Erasure, we can let it resolve before casting Opt, so they have less information to work with. Don't need more lands at the moment. Untap. Expansion Explosion's fine. I think I'm okay running out our Planeswalker here. And do we want a backup? The first one's likely to die. I think I'm still gonna keep it. Just to have a backup. Alright, Angrass Rampage makes us sacrifice our Planeswalker. Still keep Rall. Could copy a Shock, but I don't think that's necessary. And yeah, expansion. So if our opponent doesn't interact with Rall or our hands, we've got infinite damage next turn, double expansion plus Shock to set it up. And yeah, opponent taps out for Tamiya's Epiphany, so I think we've got it. The only thing that can mess us up is a Spell Pierce. So yeah, I guess that's the only thing that beats us. Keeps one on top, but they already played a land for the turn. Definitely keep that one. And then Shock, target our opponent. Target our opponent with Rall, expansion, copy Shock. Target opponents, expansion the expansion, target opponents, and then we've got to make sure to copy this expansion and not the other one. And there we go. This takes a second to execute, but it's pretty straightforward. And our opponent sees what's happening and concedes. Awesome, on to the next one. Alright, we're on the play, hand seems quite good. Opts to find more lands, Ascanta as our card engine, and then Shock as interaction. I think we'll lead with islands since we have two ops in hand, so next turn we can still go opt plus shock. And this turn we can opt facing a turn one gutter bones. Keep a land. And more opts. So we could run out Ascanta, or we can interact with the gutter bones first. The gutter bones not the best creature to try and kill since they can get back. So I think I'm okay running out Ascanta here. And then see where things are headed before deciding what to kill with our shock. Right, Priest of Forgotten Gods might be a better target for the shock, even though we're not playing any creatures ourselves. Don't think we need a second negate against a creature-heavy deck. And the Lightning Strike to draw. I think we'll just play land, say go. And we'll see what our opponent does. Third land untapped for Judith. Now that's a much better target for our burn spells. So we'll let that resolve. Priest attacks as well, and now we'll shock Judith. So they can't use a priest to sacrifice Judith for value. And take three. Probably should have cast our opts before shocking, since we might have drawn into a fiery cannonade, and if we did, we probably didn't want to use our shock on Judith anyway. Expansion explosion, I don't think now is the time for it. Draw mountain. Opt again. And Outburst seems fine. Can deal with the creature and get us a card deeper. And do we want the lands? Putting it in the graveyard just helps us flip Ascanta sooner, so I think I'll graveyard that. Play a land, say go. And keep up all our instants. Opponent's playing white as well. So probably for Hero of Precinct 1. Among others. Think I'm fine taking three. And then end of turn we can outburst, probably just killing the gutter bones. Yeah, I think I can buy that. And take a Sulphur Falls. And now Ascanta will transform. Keeping a Lightning Strike. Say go. There's a hero. Priest attacks. If we let the priest hit us, then they can get back gutter bones. So I think I'm fine using a lightning strike on priests, even though hero is the more threatening card. But we want to be able to use Ascanta, and then next turn we can maybe main phase, kill the hero. Think we can take an Ionize. Ral's a good one too. Think I'm still in favor of using Lightning Strike on Hero main phase. Play land, say go, keep up Ionize and Ascanta. And the opponent's just too far behind, so once we start leveraging our powerful Ascanta the Sunken Ruin, opponent's gonna struggle to keep up. Alright, we're on the play. Hands is okay. Not great against a creature-heavy deck, but against a non-creature deck we've got double negate. So it's a bit of a gamble, but one that I'm willing to keep here. And we can opt on turn one. Facing steam vents tapped, so the negates are gonna be good. Think we can bottom the land for now. Play Sulphur Falls, say go. And then next turn we can play a tapped steam vents. Discovery's fine, no need to counter that one. Want to keep the negates for Planeswalkers, Search for Ascantas, that type of card. Don't think we'll have to Fiery Cannonade here, so don't think we need our third land untapped. Opponent on Grixis. And now we can just Ral's Outburst their face end of turn if they don't do anything. Alright, Nicol Bolas is a good one. So I guess we'll discard Cannonade. Now we could stand back the Outburst in case we can combine it with another burn spell to take out Nicol Bolas. Or we can fire it off anyway and then let the Nicol Bolas hit us for a few times. I think I want to use my mana. and then expansion, explosion, or outbursts. It's close. I think I'm going with another outburst. Untap, lightning strike. Alright, so next turn we can try and kill Nicol Bolas. Or we can just keep burning their face. Although I'm not sure we're outracing the 4-4 here. So Nicol Bolas gets in. Thought Erasure will negate. Another lightning strike. So if we do try and kill Nicol Bolas and they have a counterspell, that's pretty bad for us. We could go for a double lightning strike, keep up negate to make sure it happens. But we're also using a lot of resources here. Nicol Bolas already met his discard. Now we're using two spells to get rid of it. We've got 9 points of burn in hand. Is burning the opponent out realistic? Probably not. So kind of a tough spot. If we try and fight over a counterspell, we will be tapped out and our opponent gets to resolve whatever they want. Although I guess they don't have triple black, so it can be Nicol Bolas. Yeah, I guess we'll double lightning strike Nicol Bolas here. Opponent didn't seem to have a response, but I'm still gonna keep up negate here. And then hope they don't have a second Nicol Bolas to play here. It's gonna be Chandra, which is worth a negate. Opt to draw. Guess we'll cast it if we draw Ascanta and resolve it. That's a pretty big deal. Expansion Explosion I'll keep. And now we could expansion the Outburst, or we can just Outburst end of turn and then cast a bigger Explosion. Another Nicol Bolas. It's unfortunate. So I guess we'll Outburst their face. Find a Rahl, which can kill Nicol Bolas, and then discard expansion. And hope they can't counter this. Alright, got our Planeswalker in play. You can maybe provide a bit of advantage if he survives. Rampage makes a sacrifice. And our hand's just two burn spells, so not the best spot to be in, but we're still alive. And our opponent doesn't have any card advantage here that they can leverage. So this is a spot where drawing Expansion Explosion would be quite good. More Planeswalkers. Ascanta. Likely getting countered, but I think we still try. Alright, that resolves. And yeah, Grixis doesn't have a great way to deal with an enchantment. Thought Erasure will just burn their face. Opponent down to 7. And yeah, Ascanta just needs to find a couple burn spells, and we're good. Keep that one, transform. And pass a turn. Outburst their face. Get a land. Activate Ascanta. Misses. That's a lot of lands. Alright, I guess we'll opt main phase. Bottom the land. There's our expansion explosion. So that could be enough to burn them out, but I'll do it end of turn here. I guess we can just activate Ascanta, we're not forced to explosion. And I guess find an outburst, which we can fire off here. Opponent doesn't seem to have any counter spells. Get a shock. And we can just shock their face here. And we still have explosion if that doesn't work. Alright, and that does it. Their opponent must have had a handful of removal spells that they couldn't use. Alright, that's gonna do it for today. Wanna thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day. I also want to thank all my patrons for being part of the channel, and you can become a patron yourself today and decide the topic of future videos over at patreon.com/legendvd.